Standard front wheel alignment is the way of making sure that the wheels are operating parallel with each
other
and that the tire meets the road at the correct angle. Front wheel alignment assures that the rear wheel trail the front wheel in a parallel path while moving in straight forward direction. The specification for the angles created between the suspension, steering wheels and the frame of the vehicle offer from model to model. The vehicle is to be properly aligned when all these angles are according to the manufacturer's direction. The main reason for accurate alignment between the wheel are to take certain that the vehicle attain lowest amount of rolling function when rolling friction. Number two, the vehicle manages to generate maximum tire mileage. Number three, the vehicle attain stability in the dynamic condition. Number four, the vehicle allow easy steering control for the driver. Now the analyzing the faulty alignment is a subject of investigating the unusual wear of tire, damage to wheels, position of steering wheels. A road test is usually carried out to make sure that the vehicle is not pulling to one side, drifting or weaving. There are basically four angles which decide whether a vehicle is properly aligned or not. Camber, the vehicle will have wear on one side of the tire tread if the camber is out of adjustment. Custer, vehicle will face the problem with self-centering and wondering if the custer is incorrect. Custer has a negligible effect on the tire. 2. Fault to angle causes quick tire wear to both the tires event. 2. Sitting is the most ordinary adjustment procedure carried out the front wheels. Some vehicles also have facility to adjust toe on the road wheels. Number 4 is offset. Normally it causes pulling of the vehicle to one side and wobbling. So now latest laser based 3D equipment is used to set all the alignment. The following figure show a 3D wheel alignment machine. The front wheel are placed on the turntable and the measuring equipment is connected to each of the four wheels. In simple terms, a laser is used to draw a perfect box. Now, coming the main component of the wheel alignment machine. Main unit, it consists of cabinet, power supply and power and computer interface. It provides a control platform from which one can control all the operation of the machine. Number 2, cameras. 3D wheel alignment make use of high resolution camera to capture the image from your from four different targets attached to the four wheels of the vehicle while aligning. Number 3, wheel clamp and target. Target clamp assembly play vital role in the accuracy of wheel alignment machine. Generally, four target clamp assembly are provided with alignment machine. These assemblies are monitored by the camera and provided with definite sign, sign pattern for proper mounting on the field. Next is turntable. Wheel alignment machine comes with at least two mechanical turntables. These turntables are installed on the pit or lift. Front wheels of the vehicle are carefully placed on these turntables. Some turntables are provided with the protector's scale to measure turning radius of the vehicle. So in the figure we can show, see the turntable and the protector scale. Next is T-alignment checks. First one is check inflation pressure of all the tire. Tire should be recommended size and of same specification. Number two, confirm the wheel bearing for correct adjustment. Number three, check for slack ball joint loops. Number four, check the tie rod in center link, pitman arm and rack bushing for damage or looseness. Number five, examine the wear of the wheels and the tire. Check for vehicle ride height. It should be according to the manufacturer's specification. Number seven, check for steering gear slackness with the fan. Number eight is check for faulty operation on the shock absorber. Number nine, examine the control arm bushing. 11, check the stabilizer bar attachment. Number 11, check the dragging brake. Now come to the alignment procedure. First one is vehicle is carefully driven onto the alignment rack and adjust on the turntable so that they are under middle of the vehicle tire. Number two, wooden blocks are used to lock wheels which avoid rolling down of the vehicle from the alignment rack. Number three, wheel sensors are attached to each wheel and calibrate as specified by the alignment equipment manufacturer. Number four, release all the rack or turn plates. Number five, follow the procedures for the alignment equipment specified by the alignment machine manufacturer and find out all the alignment angle. So this is the procedure of the alignment. Now come to the next topic, which is adjustment of the camber. Many starts slow camber allow camber adjustment at the stock to knuckle fastening. Here a special tool is being used to hold and move the stock into alignment with the fastener loosens. Once the desired camber angle is achieved, the stock nut are tightened and tool is removed. Here the figure adjustment of camber are shown, where this one is the stock assembly, this one is the adjusting tools, this is the nuts are loosened for adjusting the camber, and this is the knuckle. Next is adjustment of custom. Here is the picture show about the adjustment of custom. The many vehicles are constructed with limited custom factory adjustment. It is advisable to prefer vehicle manufacturer service manual to adjust custom in the appropriate manner. The next is adjustment of toe-in or is the last angle that should be adjusted and needs correction, as where occur at each steering joint such as tie rod end. The forces exert on the linkage by the tire jack on tend to cause a tie out condition. Front wheel drive FWD vehicle transmit engine power through the front wheel. Many manufacturers of FWD or front wheel drive vehicle specify a two-out setting. This two-out setting helps to compensate for the slight toe-in effect of the engine torque being transferred through the front wheel. Now, new alignment equipment display in degree of toe inside of inches of toe. So now new alignment equipment. So therefore, new alignment equipment display. New alignment equipment display in degree of toe. Degree of toe instead of degree of toe instead of inch of toe. Just remember that positive plus toe means toe in, and negative minus toe means toe out. To make sure that the steering wheel is straight after the setting the toe, the steering wheel must be locked in the straight ahead position while the toe is being adjusted. Another term used to describe the steering wheel position is spoke. To lock the steering wheel, always use a steering wheel lock that presses against the steel and the outer rim of the steering. So students, here you can learn about the wheel alignment and its procedure. So thank you, class.